Hello friends, today I am going to explain parts of the circle by homemade circular geoboard. To make the homemade circular geoboard, we require here thermocol sheet, rounder, colorful sheet, scissor, fevicol. Okay, so you can see here I have used this thermocol sheet. I have cut it in a circular shape. So this thermocol sheet you can cut in a circular shape. Okay, using rounder you can make the circle, and then you require here thumb pins, colorful sheet you can stick on thermocol sheet. Use your thumb pins to show the center of the circle, and on all the boundaries you can put here this thumb pin. Now we can explain all the parts of the circle by using this geoboard. So this is the line segment. Okay, so a line segment joining center of the circle to any one point on the circle is known as radius. Now these two points are on the circle, so joining any two points on the circle is known as chord. This point is on the circle, this point is on the circle, so again joining a line segment joining two points on the circle is known as a chord. So what is the difference between this chord and this chord? Both are the chords. Okay, so here you can observe that this chord is passing through from the center. So a chord which passes through from the center is called a diameter. And diameter is the longest chord of the circle. Here you can see that the length of the diameter is this. Here you can say that the length is greater, again length is greater, again length is greater. So diameter is the longest chord of the circle. Now here you can see that only this small part, if I am talking about this small part, so small portion of the circle is known as an arc. Small portion of the circle is known as an arc. So this is the smaller one, so this is called minor arc. If I talk about this bigger one, suppose I will cover the bigger area. Okay, so this is also an arc, so this is called major arc. This one is minor arc, this one is major arc. Now this is the chord. Okay, and this is your arc. Once again, this is your chord, and now the way I am rotating, this is an arc. So the area enclosed between a chord and an arc is known as segment. This area is known as segment. So this is the smaller part, so this is known as minor segment. Similarly, if I cover this bigger part, okay, this is your chord, and suppose I will cover this bigger area, so the area enclosed between a chord and an arc is known as segment. Since this is the bigger portion, this is known as major segment. Now this one is radii, this is your another radii. So here you can see that two radii, one radius, second radius. Radii is the plural of radii, that's what I'm using. You can see here two radii. So area enclosed between two radii is called a sector. Once again, area between two radii is known as a sector. Okay, now here we can see that here also this is one radii and this is also another radius. Two radii are there. So this is also a sector. Area enclosed between two radii is known as sector. This is also a sector. This is also a sector. So what is the difference? Here you can see that 90 degree. Okay. And you can say that this is 1/4 part of the circle. So 1/4 part of the circle is known as a quadrant, or the area enclosed between two radii where they make 90 degree angle, then this area is known as quadrant. Okay, suppose if I cover this and this one, so just forget about this half part. So this half part is known as semicircle. So half of the circle is known as semicircle. Now suppose I am drawing one line which intersects the circle at two different points, then this line is known as secant of the circle. The line which intersects the circle at two different points, then this is called secant of the circle. If a line touch the circle only at one point, look at here, this is the one point, then this is known as tangent of the circle. Now the perimeter means the boundary. The perimeter of the circle is called circumference. So if you will open this, measure this length, so whatever length is there from here to here, this is called circumference of the circle. So this is the way we can explain all the parts of the circle by using this homemade circular geoboard. Now for recapitulation, you can ask students or you can ask your child to keep one circle, give one thread or certain ribbon the way I am using, and whatever you are saying, child will show this on the circle. Whether it is a classroom, teachers can also use, or at home, parents, you can ask your child to show all the parts of the circle. Example, the one thing you need to assume that here is a circle, or you can stick one bindi or anything so that the child will remember this is the circle. Okay, the first thing, if I am asking chord, so child will hold this. This is the chord. Diameter. So this is the diameter. Okay. Line segment joining any two points on the circle is known as diameter. Line segment joining any two points on the circle. This is a chord. And a chord which passes through from the center is known as diameter. Every time ask your child or students to say all the sentences in their mind. Radius, so center of the circle and this. So a line segment joining center of the circle to any point on the circle is known as radius. Arc, so a small portion of the circle is known as arc. Small portion of the circle is known as arc. This is minor arc. This will be major arc. Sector. So, area enclosed between two radii is known as sector. Quadrant. 1/4 of the circle is known as quadrant. Semicircle. Half of the circle is known as semicircle. Secant. A line which intersects the circle at two different points is known as secant. Tangent. A line which touches the circle at one point is known as tangent of the circle. So this is the way we can do revision or we can recap the parts of circle. Even student and your kid will also enjoy this. Thank you for watching today's video.